In this session, we have Chris Rawlings again on our channel, and this time we will be talking about artificial intelligence, about ChatGPT and OpenAI, all these new tools appearing in the industry, which you can use to make Amazon PPC more effective and more profitable. So if you will enjoy this session, don't forget to click like and subscribe. So make sure that you like this video even now that we attract more viewers. And let's invite the one and the only Chris Rawlings. Hi, Chris.
What's up, dude? I'm glad to be back, and I'm glad that our lights match. Look at that.
Yeah.
Awesome. I'm telling you straight up, 1 year from now, I will be a famous YouTuber. I mean, with lights like these, get out of here.
Well,
I'm going to be a famous YouTuber for sure.
I'm the next level. You need like Sophie Society, blue mic.
Yeah. Oh, you know what? You're right. That's my next thing. The mic, it blends in with my shirt. Huh.
Yeah. Yeah, it's invisible. All right. So today we'll talk about ChatGPT. Everyone who is watching, feel free to ask your questions. If you're watching live, ask in the chat box. And if you're watching the recording, put your questions in the comments below and Chris will answer them as soon as possible. So where shall we start? Chris,
let's do rock and roll. I'm live streaming.
Okay.
All right.
Who is Chris? Maybe introduce yourself and then...
Sure. Before we get into this. My name is Chris Rawlings. I'm the owner of Sophie Society. Launched over 2,000 products on Amazon. Serve between 80 and 150 brands every single month, either managing their PPC or increasing their conversion or investing in them. I've founded, invested in, or partnered in dozens of brands myself. Started my first multi-million-dollar brand back in 2015, which freed me to travel around the world and live out of a motorcycle, and most recently move into a tiny home van, which is really fun and really exciting. So this industry has allowed my dreams to come true. I like to, help keep advancing it because I think we're still in day one, and help make other brands' dreams come true. I'm originally a scientist. I have a degree in physics. So I bring the scientific method into this space and do a lot of experimentation and hypothesis generation to find out what works, which is what leads me to what we're talking about today, which is a very hypey topic since OpenAI came out with this tool called ChatGPT at the end of November. So much hype about it because it's just something the world has never really seen before, or at least the masses have never really seen before, even though AI has been used on the back end in lots of tools for years now. Everyone now knows about it because everyone has access to it, which is pretty cool. And so we're going to try to cut through the hype a little bit, be real, and talk about how Amazon sellers really can actually use ChatGPT in their businesses, what it works for, what it doesn't work for, what you can rely on it to do, what you really shouldn't rely on it to do, and how it can help your PPC perform better too.
And while Chris is preparing his presentation, which I believe he has some, I want to welcome all the viewers who are watching, tuning in live. Venecia Digital, Ruby from Philippines, Mr. Makrufi from Hackerstown, Mut Fair from Pakistan, and Retro here for Chris Rawlings. So Retro Gaming just tuned in for you, Chris. Wow. And I wanted to mention that 3 months ago we activated the like button, so make sure you'll click the like below this video at any point you enjoy this session.
And, nice.
Barbanov Nikolai is tuning in from Baltics. Brent is here. Yo, Chris, looking fine in them glasses. All right.
It's so sad. I'm getting old, bro. I need these to see now. Ugh. I've had glasses for a long time, but I rarely use them. But my eyes have been so tired from working so much that I'm actually wearing them.
All right. So we see your presentation, Rapid Evolution. And
let's rock and roll. Cool. Yeah. So, what are these AI tools that are available to us as e-commerce entrepreneurs all about now is the words that you see on the screen right here, rapid evolution. There are a lot of things that these tools can help us do, but there's a lot of things that they can't help us do. And the reason why I reached out to Augustus to do this little webinar and video together is because I got really excited, especially having a degree in physics and having done a lot of coding myself in my past, and just really being just a straight up dork. I got really, really stoked about this and wanted to find out, is this shiny object? Is this actually meaningful for us? Is it not? And I was watching a lot of content, specifically content about how Amazon sellers and e-commerce business owners were using ChatGPT. And I was like, not impressed. I just thought, you know what? I don't really like these use cases that much. And it just didn't really excite me. So we started experimenting in my company, Sophie Society. And I actually found that there were some things that were actually valuable and exciting, even in its current state. And the most important thing is that the current state is only a tiny fraction of what these tools are going to evolve into just this year. So whether or not you think some of these use cases are material enough or significant enough for you to implement now, in my view, I think it's really a huge mistake to overlook these tools, because we're going through the year of 2023 is a fundamental paradigm shift for all entrepreneurs. And it's this: up until this year, all the years of human history up through the end of 2022, the most powerful skill a human being could have was to influence and motivate other human beings. That's what being an entrepreneur actually is. It's influencing and motivating a team to accomplish the mission of making the revenues, producing and selling some kind of product or service. Because the most powerful computer in the world is the human brain, or was up until now. We're now moving into a space where it's going to be the case where that's not necessarily the one and only top skill that a human being can have to become successful, because it's not necessarily going to be the most powerful computer in the world, the human brain. You know, you can get a human brain for pretty cheap. You know, you could hire someone full-time in the Philippines for $700 a month, right? But there are things now that we can see that artificial intelligence is starting to be able to do just as well, and certain things better than a human. So therefore, it makes sense for an entrepreneur to start learning how to inspire and motivate these tools rather than just learning how to inspire and motivate human beings and organize them to accomplish a goal. So that's very philosophical, but this is the reason that I personally spend time on this and don't see it as a shiny object. I do see it as the future of entrepreneurship for humanity going forward. So things that AI is useful for now. One-person teams, it's really useful for, because you're so strapped on time and resources. It can help you get things done faster. Maybe not necessarily better, but it can definitely help you get things done faster. And things that you wouldn't have had time to do before, you can just get them done, like the minimum viable version of it done. And I'm going to show you guys some examples during this presentation of ways that you can do that. So a one-person team, it's honestly a godsend. Because things you just like, man, I just don't have time to do all of these things. Now, this grants you the ability to get things done even though you don't have the time. And I'm going to show you, like I said, some examples of things that you can do that you wouldn't have had time for before. Brands with a high number of SKUs. So if a brand has many dozens or hundreds of SKUs, it's very difficult for them to stay up to date with all of them, especially when it comes to updating listing content. So AI is especially useful for them. And I'm going to show you why later on in this presentation. Brands with really limited resources. If there's a brand that's kind of, this is a similar point to the one person teams. If you're like really struggling, no one has time, everyone's overloaded. So many things haven't been updated in months or quarters or years. And you're just really strapped for resources, money, and time, these tools can really help you. can really help you rise out of that. And then brands that have fallen behind on updates. You know, a brand that hasn't updated a listing in 2 years, you know, you'd be shocked how many 7- and 8-figure brands like just don't touch their listings. And that's not healthy. It's not a good thing. Brands that are doing well that don't touch their listings are doing well in spite of the fact that they don't touch their listings, not because of the fact that they don't touch their listings. So yeah, it can help you make updates to your listing, to your packaging, to your email sequences, to anything that has to do with content, to your ads. These AI tools can actually help with. It's pretty crazy. Some things that they won't help you with, at least not right now. It's not going to help you write better than a human. At least this is my experience so far using these tools, especially ChatGPT. You don't get writing that's better than a good copywriter could write. But you do get pretty good copy that you can start with that brings you 70% of the way there. And then you just add the spice and flair on your own. And not that AI can't add spice and flair, it actually can, which is crazy. But yeah, so you're typically not going to get writing that's better than a human being would, but it just generates it like 1,000 times faster. Like what would take you like 2 hours, it would take like 30 or 40 seconds. So it's wild. Generating plug and play content, it's not going to help you do that. Like I said before, usually it's going to get you 70, maybe 80% of the way there, and you add, you know, you add and adjust from there, but you're not really going to be able to put in a prompt, get the output, and then just literally copy and paste it in. That's not a reasonable expectation at this point in time of AI's, you know, these AI tools advancement and replacing humans. So if you think you're going to like fire your copywriter and replace them just with ChatGPT, it's probably not true. Most likely it's just going to make your existing humans more effective and make them be able to produce more. Actually, I have a friend who's also a mentor in the Titan Network, like me, that's what this shirt is, who said he basically went to the creatives on his team, and he's run multiple 7-figure brands. And he said, no one's getting fired because of these AI tools, but you all have to produce double, basically. And these are the guys that are producing, like, you know, social content and stuff like that for their brand. So it's actually valid what he's saying, because these tools greatly increase. I mean, he could have said you have to produce 5 times, you have to produce 10 times based on what these tools allow you to do. But he was nice and said you have to produce double. So yeah, that's the basics of it. AI will help you iterate faster, stay up to date, and increase the effectiveness and efficiency of your team members. AI won't help you reduce the team member count, and it won't help you replace people. So the main things that I've realized about these tools in their current state is that they help you do the things that you know you should do, but you won't. And we all have those, especially Amazon brands. There's so many things to do. Got to write product inserts to get my review velocity up. I got to do an 8-email sequence to follow up with everyone who opts in. I got to try out these video ads. I got to try out different sponsored display ads with custom creatives. I want to try remarketing. I want to try Google traffic. I want to try TikTok. There's so many things that you know you should be doing or should be trying that successful brands are doing, but you won't. You can't, because there's only so much time in the day. What these tools allow you to do is increase effectiveness and efficiency to the point where you're able to handle more of the things that you should be doing. And that's cool. It's not that it's necessarily giving you capabilities that you didn't have before. It's just allowing you to do more. So that's pretty cool. We're having a little discussion before we started recording here, me and Augustus, and we were talking about some of the whack answers that we were getting from ChatGPT. And one of the things I wanted to mention on this is that for, in particular, talking about ChatGPT, it's only trained on data up through 2021. So don't expect it to be current. You can't say like, what was the stock price of such and such stock this morning? Like, it's not going to know. It's only trained on data up through 2021. So cool. Let's start going through these actual use cases, guys. Again, is early stages. So I'm still experimenting this with myself. We're only a couple weeks in here. This is going to evolve, and I'm sure this video is going to be out of date 3 months from now, or maybe even sooner. But we'll do another one then. But these are the ways that we've found can actually be useful.
And by the way, we have a comment from Jennifer. She says, it creates better copy than me mostly. I am mind blown. Yep, showed it to my team. They are amazed. So people are already using it. And...
nice. Nice, Jennifer. Yeah, cool topic. Yeah. No, I mean, honestly, it's good. It's good. I said it's not better than a human, but that's because you really have to like proofread this stuff. But it really does a good job. It's honestly, it's shocking. This is why it's taken the world by storm. We'll get into some examples. So let's go. So the first use case is to use ChatGPT to rapidly recalibrate listing copy from top converting terms. So this is something that should be a standard practice for brands. What do I mean by this? It's going into your search term report, right? And getting the top converting terms recently, like last 60 days, and making sure that your listing is abreast of those terms. And many times you'll find that it isn't. So what you're going to see in this video here is I'm going to copy all the bullets. I'm not going to do anything to them. I'm literally just copying and pasting all the bullets of this listing here. And what I'm going to say is I'm going to say, hey, ChatGPT, take all of these top converting terms that I've noticed from my advertising reports and sprinkle them into these bullets. Rewrite these bullets in an elegant way, but with these terms. So now I'm updating my bullet points, which is one of the top indexed parts of a listing, with the terms that are converting best and are the highest searched for my particular product. So see, look, I've got my search term report up here. And if you're wondering how we hit those ACoS levels, well, you got to hire us to do your PPC. I take the terms and look, there's some stuff that's, you know, it's not very intuitive, like chips, food. This is a cacao butter product, right? Wafers, baking, chips. Like these are things maybe I didn't think of. And indeed, they're not in the bullets of this product. So I'm telling ChatGPT, rewrite the Amazon listing bullet points below, but include the keywords. And then boom, it literally spits them out one by one. They're similar to the original bullet points. The meaning of the bullet points hasn't changed, but it includes these words that it didn't have before. So now I'm going to be indexed. And now I'm also speaking the customer's language. And that took me literally 1 minute, 60 seconds. And that same thing could be done with A+ content. The same thing could be done with storefront writing. The same thing could even be done with a title, although that's so easy, you might as well do that yourself. But this is what I mean. You guys see what I'm saying is if you have lots of listings, you could just do this really quick. This could be a monthly thing, or at the very least a quarterly thing, where it's somebody just does it. It doesn't have to be even need to be a skilled person anymore. You don't have to hire a copywriter to do it. You can literally just do this. Have a VA just do this. Write up an SOP that the search term report is downloaded. All the like critical long tail keywords are copied, and then they use ChatGPT to rewrite the bullets and they update the bullets. So it's a simple thing, and it's something that we all know we should do, right? But we're not doing it. Let's be honest. How many of you guys are actually updating your listings in this way every quarter, all of your listings? Probably very few of you, but you should be, because the customer search term trends do change, and they can change fast in some cases, especially the long tail keywords, misspellings, things of that nature. New use cases like that old example that Bradley Sutton used to use from Helium 10 of In My Coffee, and a collagen company that didn't even have the word coffee, even though one of the number one use cases of it was putting it in their coffee. These are the types of things you can now make these changes really, really quickly to your listing. And one of the best sources of this is your search term report. So again, this isn't allowing you to do something that you couldn't do before. Yeah, you could do this before, but you just saw me do it in a GIF in 60 seconds. So now there's literally no excuse not to do it, because it doesn't take skill and it doesn't take time. It's literally just a decision. So now if I have tons of listings, I can push changes to all of them very, very fast. And that allows me to stay abreast with my indexing and also with using language that's consistent with the search terms that are being used by my ideal customers. Because if they came from your search term report and you organized it by purchases and by conversion rate, you know that they're great terms. Okay. So that's cool. Is this making sense to people? I want to hear in the chat box. You guys stay with me, stay engaged.
Yeah, please let us know your reactions. And I see Jennifer says it's unreal. Retro is asking, how can we use it for PPC? I guess we will still talk about this, right?
Yeah. So a lot of Henry, this stuff that you Henry can use. Says,
amazing. Yeah.
So basically things that you used to do once per year, you can bump it up to once per quarter. Things you used to do once per quarter, you could bump it up to once per month, because it allows a VA with a simple SOP that you create once to handle copy changes on your listing. And this does affect your PPC. This number one point is one of the top ways you can use it for PPC, to answer that one question, because it allows the traffic to be more relevant to the listing. So if you're updating your bullets, if you're updating your title more frequently with terms that the customers are using that convert for your product, you're going to convert a larger portion of them, a significantly larger portion of them. And then your PPC performance is better. So the PPC performance isn't all about just adjusting bids and budgets. It's much, much deeper than that. It's fractal. You have to go a layer down, try to get the most relevant traffic and make your listing the most relevant to the traffic that you do get. So this is all, you know, one holistic system that we're looking at here.
I wanted to say that we have more reactions. Leo Livni says, yes, I already use it. Amazing and unbelievable. Rainy says, excited to learn more about the PPC aspect.
Nice. Yeah. So here's another way that's one of my most exciting, my ones that I'm most excited about, is using ChatGPT to have a conversation with your customer avatar. Now, this is another way that you can make your listing more relevant to the traffic that you drive to it. So take a look at this. Say I take my search term report from my Amazon advertising. I take the top converting terms and ask ChatGPT to define the customer avatar of a customer who's searching these particular terms, and then give them those terms. I recorded this live, and it shows that sometimes you can't take the first answer that ChatGPT is going to tell you. In this case, I wasn't super impressed with the very first answer that it gave you, but then I dug in, and the cool thing is, this is a gigantic artificial intelligence that's trained on like trillions of data points, right? So it gave me a pretty generic answer. I gave it all of these search terms, and it said the customer avatar who searched the above terms is health conscious individual interested in using natural and organic ingredients in cooking and skincare, might be looking for cacao butter products and in organic products, interested in using pink Himalayan sea salt in cooking. And it's like, okay, that's not very helpful, but what kinds of influencers does this person follow? And then I get a little bit more. Influencers that focus on natural living, health and wellness bloggers, beauty gurus, food bloggers who focus on organic ingredients, influencers that specialize in cooking and recipe development, those who focus on self-care. And then I said, what other kinds of products might they buy? And now I start to get a little bit more. Natural and organic ingredients in the cooking, skincare products, lotions, soaps, face serums made of organic ingredients, natural organic supplements such as vitamins and herbal supplements, natural and organic cleaning products such as laundry detergent and dish soap, natural and organic baby products such as diapers and baby wipes, natural and organic pet products such as food and grooming products, hair care, food items, personal care products, home products like candles and diffusers. So now I've got ideas for other types of products. First of all, I could do cross promotions with those guys. Second of all, I can get ideas for new product placement ads to throw out. And I can also get ideas for complementary products and other products to launch next for my ideal customer avatar. And I say, what other brands might the customer purchase? And I'm hoping that it's going to give me some actual specific real brands. And by the way, you have to take into account that the data that it's trained on is only up through 2021. but it actually does. It gives me some real brands. Core Organics, Juice Beauty, Willenda, Garden of Life, Solgar, Nature's Plus, Seventh Generation, Nature's Path, Bob's Red Mill. So it's medium, large, small brands, all different types of brands it's giving me. And now I can go out and find brands to advertise on. I could find brands to do collabs with, cross promotions with. And also I'm going to be better at writing my own listings because I can kind of, instead of just doing the exercise of creating a sheet and creating a customer avatar by just thinking of everything by myself, I can now sort of have a conversation with my customer. And this defining customer avatar concept, this is something that we actually teach it in Titan, the mastermind that I'm a leader in. It's one of the most important things a brand can do. The one nine-figure brand owner who actually sold his basket of brands for nine figures that I know is uses this exercise before starting any new brand first. It's the first thing he does is define a customer avatar. But now, rather than just having a bunch of words on a sheet, you can actually sort of converse with your customer, which I find really exciting. And there's all different types of use cases that you can use from that, from adjusting your listing to making partnerships to creating email sequences and so many other things as well. So,
and Chris,
I loved.
Yeah. You mentioned search term report, and Alicia is asking, what is the search term report? Can you answer this probably basic question where she can download it?
Yeah, we should probably like post like a screenshot to it, but it's in Amazon Seller Central on in Amazon Advertising under your reports. You'll easily find it. Everyone has access to it. Every seller has access to the search term report. There's a lot of different types of reports you can generate, but the search term report is the one that you want. So here's another way that we started to experiment with recently. This is a different tool. It's not ChatGPT. It's called Midjourney, and it's actually in Discord. So it's a little bit clunky to use, but it's really cool. And this tip is for visuals. So this tool actually creates visuals from prompts. And these visuals, I found if you tweak it enough and you figure out how to use the right prompts, you can actually get a starting place for ad creatives. And as most of you guys probably know, since last year, you're now able to input custom ad creatives. So it's not just your product showing up anymore on Amazon. You can upload custom creatives. And I think up until now, that process was, I didn't see many brands doing what Facebook advertisers typically do, which is come up with like dozens of different ad creatives and test out which one is converting best. And then the one that is, create variations of that to find which converts best and then find which is converting best from those variations and then keep branching out like that. That's kind of the Gary Vee approach to advertising. But I haven't seen many Amazon sellers do that. And the main reason is because it's not a creative first business. Up until recently, you couldn't even upload any custom creative. Except for, you know, somewhere around 2 years ago when you could start doing sponsored display video in search results. But besides that, there wasn't much creative. So Amazon brands, like unlike other brands in their advertising, Amazon advertising, it's not, custom creative hasn't been a huge part of it. Well, that is going to change. And we could tell by the direction that Amazon is going in that it's going to change because Amazon has started to give brands more and more creative freedom. You've seen in the last just year plus, the brand section, brand story section of a listing, the Amazon Live, where you could do live videos, the custom creative and sponsored display ads, Amazon posts, the new capabilities for Amazon storefronts, new premium A+ content. Amazon is basically just saying to brands, hey, use more creative, get more creative and use creatives in your listings and in your advertising. So these tools can be a way to get more ideas and also create variations on images that work well with custom creatives in Amazon advertising. Now, I'll say this, is that we don't have that we're only just now starting to experiment with this. These tools are pretty new. We don't have the data back to, I don't have a case study to show you guys. You're on this journey with me. So we're experimenting together. These are the ideas that I have that our company has started to experiment with brands. But this is the type of thing I'm talking about. So in sponsored display, you could see this is how ads show up when you upload a custom creative in all the different formats. So this is pretty cool because you could see how you could create a number of different ads with a number of different creatives. And maybe you're doing remarketing or maybe you're doing category targeting, but you can start to see if you have a number of different creatives uploaded for a custom creative ad, which creatives are doing best. Then you can use some of these tools to create variations of it. And that's the really exciting thing is I think the variation creation. So this is a tool that I was talking about. It's called Midjourney. You can find it just by Googling the word Midjourney. It's you have to sign up for Discord and then you're added to this Discord group. And this is how it works. So you basically create a prompt that the tool will use to generate an image. And you can see what I typed here was there's a lot of words here, and I'll tell you why I use so many words. But it's saying an attractive young woman using coconut oil in the kitchen to cook. And then I have a lot of other stuff, size ratio, incredibly detailed, sharpened details, cinematic production, 8K, cinematography, photorealistic, epic composition. I'm going to show you guys why I have all those words. This is just from experimentation and observation of other prompts, what produces an actual realistic result, because it literally could produce any image. You can see when I scroll through these other people's images, a lot of them are cartoons or like graphics. But for mine, look at that. I actually got images of women in the kitchen using coconut oil. Now, when you zoom in, you could see these aren't perfect. So, whoops, I lost it. Well, anyways, they weren't perfect. Some of them, like when you really zoomed in, were a little bit off or needed adjustment. And that's what you find with these AI image generation tools. And that's why I say it's a good place to start. When you're making Amazon posts or you're making custom creative for sponsored display ads, you can use these tools. Okay, first of all, I didn't mention this either because I think I didn't get far enough in the video, but you can upload a video to start with or a picture to start with. So you can start with an existing picture and then tell it to make a variation of it, which is really cool. You could say, hey, start with this picture, except add the dad to the picture or add a child, which is really, really dope because as you guys know, for things like Amazon posts, Amazon doesn't allow you to upload the same image twice. Well, now you basically have unlimited capacity to create variations of images. But you do have to learn this word. And this is something that you guys are going to hear a lot of this year. So if this is your first time hearing this term, prompt engineering, it won't be the last because this is basically the key to getting what you want out of these AI tools. I am no expert in prompt engineering. I'm just learning all this stuff myself and doing the research, but I know I will be because this is the key to harnessing the power of these artificial intelligence tools is creating the correct prompts. And you find when you start to mess with these tools, and I really encourage you guys to do it yourself, like get these tools, download Midjourney, look at DALL-E, especially ChatGPT, and just start messing with it. It's free for now. Rumor has it that they're spending like $3 million a day just to keep these live and free. Maybe it's even more now, but so it probably won't be free for long. So I'd really encourage you guys to try this out yourself, but you'll find that you have to kind of be careful how you ask things because you get answers back that you realize, wow, that's right, but it's not really what I was looking for. So you find out that you have to be super duper specific, which is why you saw me type such a long paragraph rather than just woman in the kitchen with coconut oil. And here's some useful prompts when you're generating real photos, like photorealistic images with these AI tools. I'm not going to read all of these for you guys, but there's some of them you could take a screenshot. But also, if you just shoot me an email at hello@sophiesociety.com or you scan this with your phone, this is my Instagram, hippie mogul. You could just shoot me a DM, and we actually have like a list. It's casual, so don't expect like a well-designed white paper, but a list of prompts that we use to generate quality copy and generate quality images. Because like I said, if I go back, you know, look at some of the other images in this Discord app, they're like cartoons and all kinds of crazy art and stuff like that. So really to generate photos that can be used to like Photoshop in a product or a render or something like that, you need to have the right prompts. So anyways, yeah, happy to share that with you guys. Again, don't expect anything super polished. You guys are on this journey with me. We did this webinar pretty quickly, and we're just experimenting with this stuff too. But you can take out your phone and scan that to grab me on Instagram or shoot me an email right there. My Instagram handle is hippiemogul. So yes. So another use case, using ChatGPT to increase the LTV of a first purchase. So here's a huge way that it can help with your PPC performance, because this has kind of become like a refrain for us inside our PPC team is everyone knows ACOS, average cost of sale, right? If I have a $100 product and I spent $30 on Amazon ads to get that purchase, my ACOS is 30%. Well, we've started to use another term, LACOS or LACOS, which is lifetime ACOS, with consumables products in particular, but really all products, because anybody can buy a product multiple times, they lose it or it wears out or whatever. The lifetime ACOS is important, but it's especially important with consumables products, skincare products, supplements, things that wear down faster, get used up, like this chapstick right here. I'm a Buddha butter fiend, dude. I put this stuff on all day. But lifetime ACOS is important because you'll find in consumables categories that the bids are really high. A lot of times brands are paying 100% ACOS, not just during launch, but for all their products throughout the life of their products, because they know they don't have to make money on the first purchase. Maybe they don't even have to make money on the second purchase. They might start making money only on the third purchase because they're willing to spend that much upfront. So the LTV or lifetime value of a product is so important when it comes to your PPC performance, because it allows you, if you know it, to spend more upfront on the ad that gets the first purchaser. And these are the things that people look at PPC so narrowly. Oh, how do I calculate my bid? Oh, how do I calculate my budget? Dude, that stuff is so elementary. If you really want your PPC to work well, you have to look at the holistic picture of why isn't your PPC performing well? Everyone that purchases your product never purchases it again. Why? Well, it's not because it's a bad product. It's because you have nothing in place to increase the lifetime value of a first purchaser. So what are some of the ways you could use ChatGPT to increase the lifetime value? Adding a product insert. This is where I get to the point that I mentioned earlier, things that you just never had the time to do before, but you know you should do. You could create a minimum viable version of it really easily now. So I went with the strategy of making a long form product insert. I said, write a 200 word product insert message for a cacao butter product with a CTA of getting the customer to scan a QR code to get a discount code for their next purchase. So what would I do with this? I would take this and just pop it into Canva and create an insert with a nice design super easily, and then send it to my manufacturer. Again, takes minutes. Like this doesn't even take me an hour. You'd want to like add a little bit more character to this, a little bit more brand character, a little more flair, and you probably have to edit it. Some things might not be true. Like it might not be for skincare or hair care. It might just be for eating. But in any case, you have somewhere to start with. So again, the things that you just didn't have time to do before, you just wouldn't do, or you're just too overwhelmed to do. Now there's literally no excuse. Like ChatGPT just wrote my whole product insert for me, including this call to action to scan a QR code. Now all I have to do is create a QR code and design it up in Canva, which any monkey could do. So that's pretty cool. So now if I don't have a product insert, I do now. Literally, it would take, you guys could end this webinar, do this in 12 minutes, send it to your manufacturer and just be done with it. All right, what's another example? So say to increase the lifetime value of a customer, so my PPC dollars go longer, right? Having a customer engagement sequence. Now that I have my product insert, what happens once they scan and get on my list? Well, I have to send them an email sequence. Well, bro, now there's literally no reason not to have an unlimited length email sequence. You could have a 20 email sequence that goes out one email every 3 days, 20 times, 50 times, because ChatGPT will continuously write more and more emails, and they're always unique and they're always new. It's really wild. So I said in this, the prompt that I used was write the first email of a customer engagement email sequence that goes out to the purchasers of a cacao butter product after they've purchased. Make it witty, funny, and with personality and character. And you know what? I really like the result that it came up with here. The subject is welcome to the cacao butter club, which is like, what? I thought that was funny. I think that's great. It says, congratulations on becoming a member of the exclusive cacao butter club. We're thrilled to have you on board and can't wait for you to experience a delicious and versatile wonder of our pure, unrefined cacao butter. And it's very conversational, right? It says, we know you're probably wondering what makes this cacao butter so special. Well, let us tell you. And then I can't read fast enough. But yeah, you guys can see it actually does have character. It shows, it reinforces the purchase that the shopper made to make them feel good about it. And yeah, and it provides a little bit of like character and pizzazz. It's also offering them a discount, which I didn't even tell them to do. but yeah, so I thought this came out pretty good. I think this would bring you 60% of the way there, at least to the first email sequence. And you can continue to prompt ChatGPT to write more and more emails. And then again, something that you would have been putting off for months or maybe ever because you just thought, oh, I'll never get that done. Now there's literally no excuse. It would take you an hour to generate 20 different emails. And all you have to do is plug them into ActiveCampaign or MailChimp and plug that into your landing page. And now, boom, you have a customer follow-up sequence that increases your lifetime value. So now you could spend more to get that first purchase when you're advertising on Amazon. It's pretty amazing. It's honestly, this is still early days stuff. And like I said, we're experimenting. You guys are along for the ride with me. But I'm shocked with the things that you could do with this. Like I said, it's not necessarily going to do things better than you, but it's going to let you do things that you didn't have time to do before. Here's another one. Use ChatGPT to pull insights from customers. So this is one that I like. I actually use this personally. I recently went on a personal retreat where I review all of my writings and my lessons and learnings from the past year. I've actually been doing this for 12 years. This year I flew to Switzerland in the Alps and I got a cabin and I just went through all of my writing and pulled out the main principles for life and for business that I learned from my stories in the last year and things that I wrote down in my journal. And I started using ChatGPT to pull the main insights out of really long bulk blocks of text. And dude, it was amazing. I literally, like I'd have a whole story about something that happened to me at a conference or at a party or something like that with little learnings and my reflections and, you know, what the chain of events and all that stuff, but it's in a big block of text because I use dictation to get it down into my journal, my online journal in my phone. And instead of reading that and trying to think about what I learned from it, I literally just pasted the whole thing without even reading it into ChatGPT. And I said, what are the top five principles that come out of this story? And it literally pulled them out and they were good. It was like, one of them was like, go deep enough into a problem to really understand it and don't give up at the first sign of a blocker. And I'm like, shit, that is a lesson I have to learn. Like, that's something like I'm always switching too quickly between tasks. I need to learn to go deeper. And like, it kept going like one by one by one. So this is actually, I think, one of the coolest uses of ChatGPT. And this is how I personally use it. Like I said, I was using it throughout my whole retreat last week. pulling insights from block text. So here's what I do, what I'm doing in this example here is I'm saying I'm using a customer review, a long customer review that was top voted, okay? So I know not only is this a long impassioned customer review, but it's top voted, so it rang true with other customers, with the most other customers. So now I have a big block review that represents the broader customers' feelings about a product as voted by them. So this is great, right? This is really valuable stuff. I take the review, I post it in here, and I ask it, what did I ask it? Shit, now I don't even remember. Let me go back. It was somewhere along the lines of, what are the top factors that that customers take into consideration before purchasing a product based on this review? Yeah, I think that was it. And so it says back, the customer seems to have considered several factors in their decision to purchase this cacao butter, including responsibility, sourced fair trade, cold pressed in the butter manufacturing process, maintaining 100% of its initial ingredients, good grade, sustainable use for skin, arrival time, expiration date, aroma, the convenience of making a homemade whipped body butter. So now we see a use case for it. The quantity that was included, the brand name, and Amazon as a platform. And then it also says that they were African American, which, dude, we got so much insight from this that you would have had to do a whole exercise or had a VA or a team member, and they probably wouldn't even have done a good job pulling out the real insights from this. And there's so much that you can do with this. So now you know what you can focus on when it comes to advertising and your visual creatives and your text creatives, your videos, etc. And now you know how you can change the copy of the title, even the primary image, even the bullet points, based on this representation, this great representation of the broader customer audience that's purchasing your product. Or maybe it's not your product. It could be the top competitor's product. So you get a lot out of this. I mean, there's a lot of actions that I would take based on this insight. Like, first of all, maybe I would make sure that my model was African American. Maybe I would make sure that they were making this whipped product at home, this homemade whipped product that she mentions, because that seems to be a primary use case, the whipped body butter. The aroma, I might highlight that in my sponsor brand video or in my custom creative for a sponsor display ad. So yeah, you get a lot out of this. And this is honestly one of my favorite ways for both on and off Amazon to use ChatGPT, is pulling the basic principles or the basic insights or the main learnings from a big block of text. And reviews are one of the best places that you can do that. You can even copy in more. You can copy in 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 reviews, so it has more data to pull from. And you can ask it other questions about it too. Like, I ask what factors are most important to the customer in their decision-making process. But you can ask anything else about what other products this customer is probably going to buy, or what would keep them from buying, or what are their favorite things about it, or the list goes on and on. You could basically have a conversation with it now. So again, I'm on this journey. You guys are on it with me. Don't judge too hard. These are the things that I think, you know, are useful for it right now. ChatGPT-4 apparently is going to be trained on 1,000 times or even more the data than ChatGPT-3 is. So I'm really excited about that too. I know that this is going to be an important skill going forward. That's why I'm investing time in it now. I don't think it's a shiny object. I don't think it's a waste of your time. Definitely don't get obsessed with it, but it's definitely worth checking out, definitely worth experimenting, and use it for the things that you know you should do, but you won't do. That's my take. If you guys want more advice like this, we're actually doing a challenge. It's called the Profitable PPC Challenge on February 20th. You can scan this QR code right here for access to that. It's a 5-day challenge. Every day we go through actual actionable content, and we use data from our own accounts to show you what's really working. We have some really crazy secret shit in here, guys. It's crazy. Last time, 2 or 3 people cried out of joy because they were so shocked by how much value they got. We go through a lot of really ninja stuff. Like there's an example of this. There's a type of retargeting that no one even knows about, not even Amazon knows about. We call it self-targeted product placement targeting. It produces super low ACoS, like down to like 7-6%. It's low volume, but it's super low ACoS and it's consistent. We're now doing it across all our brands. I mentioned this on a video once. I've never taught it anywhere but inside the challenge. I mentioned it though one time in a video, and I actually got emailed from Amazon. An Amazon VP emailed me and said, "We saw this video about this retargeting thing. Is this a hack? Is this real?" They didn't even know about it. That's how crazy and secret it was. And that's because, you know, our guys are doing PPC for brands all day, every day. I literally just came out of our internal mastermind about an hour before this webinar started, where we went deep on our own strategies and our own tactics and the experiments we're running. We are at the forefront of this. We're at the cutting edge of Amazon PPC. And if you guys are interested and you're applicable, I'd love to see you there. Unfortunately, if you don't currently have a brand or you're not currently spending ad dollars, this is not for you. So just wait until the next time. We will do it again later on in the year. But if you are currently on Amazon, you're currently spending ad dollars and you want to do better, this is for you. If you are the brand owner, that is. So scan this QR code with your phone. That'll get you there. Otherwise, Augustus will drop the link if you have no ability to scan this.
Martin says, how to scan the code when you're watching on the smartphone? So you will find the link also in the description. In the first line of the description of this video is the link. So just open that and click it and subscribe. Of course, there is a fee for that. It's not for free, right? But you need to cover the
cost. No, it's not. Organizing. Yeah, if you are watching this live, I think we are still in early bird for another 2 or 3 days because the challenge is on the 20th. So it's tickets are $47 now. They'll be bumped up to $97 in either 2 or 3 days. So you guys are still at early bird prices if you're watching this live.
All right, amazing. And we heard a lot of good feedback from the people participating in the challenge last time. So I hope people
tons
will join.
Yeah, you could see it on this page if you scan this QR code. I mean, the feedback was absolutely insane. Like it was, we focus on over delivery. You actually get like custom help in office hours and a 24/7 private custom chat for the actual issues that you're dealing with. So it's not just, you know, like a webinar. This is like it actually takes serious commitment. Like you need to be able to commit to the time. And if you can't, we kick you out or we don't let you in the first place. You have to commit to actually showing up every day, coming with your issues, doing the homework. You know, if you really want to get better, you have to show up. And you'll be around other committed folks though. For those of you that are committed to improving your PPC, that's a good thing, is that you're surrounded by other committed people. Oh, and then finally, just wanted to put this on the screen again in case anybody missed it. You can tag me on Instagram here just by scanning this code or searching Hippie Mogul, or hit me with hello@sophiesociety.com if you have any questions. And if you want that list of prompts that we have casually, again, don't have crazy high expectations for that. This is just things that we're observing. You know, we're all figuring this out together. So if you want that, hit me up. I'm happy to send it to you in a Google Doc.
All right, perfect. We have a few questions from the audience. And of course, I want to remind everyone, if you're enjoying and enjoyed the content, enjoyed these tricks Chris shared, don't forget to hit like button below the video. We have more than 30 likes at the moment, and we need more.
Nice.
And let's see. Venezia is asking, how can ChatGPT be used for analyzing Amazon PPC reports? Do you have some ideas?
So the way that we have been testing it out and using it is by pulling out insights from it and using those reports to change copy. I haven't been using it to pull the quantitative analysis out of the reports that's necessary for budget and bid adjustment. And I don't think it's appropriate for that. We all know how to do that already, which is, you know, you sort your search term reports by purchases and then look at the highest converting, highest purchase rate products and determine what actions need to be taken, either negating keywords or advancing keywords based on their performance. And that's not something that ChatGPT or any AI tool that I know of is effective at, except for quote unquote AI tools that use AI in the background, like Quartile. That's essentially what they do, is just analysis of those. I don't know if it's really AI or not, but it's analysis of those reports and adjusting the campaigns based on it. So I wouldn't make my campaign adjustments using these tools. The real way to use these tools to make your PPC more effective is using them to integrate PPC with the rest of your company. So using them to update the content in your listing based on the search terms that are doing the best, or the misspellings or the crazy, you know, words that you didn't expect that customers start searching that you're finding from your auto campaigns, or like I mentioned before, or increasing the lifetime value of the first purchase of your product so that you can spend more upfront and you can handle higher A costs because your LA costs, your lifetime A cost, goes up. These are the types of things that allow it to help your PPC. It's not going to help you like manage your bids and budgets.
Comments from the previous slides you were showing. Rainy sure. says, I've used it for creating my title, description, everything. It's awesome. So she's just happy about ChatGPT.
Oh, nice.
It's a massive, the massive amount of data points in what is what it makes so powerful. And actually, she brings a good point. She says people need to start using this while it's in beta, because at some point they will start monetizing ChatGPT.
Yeah, everyone's saying that. I'm not sure when, or I don't know that for sure, but I do know that it's costing them through the nose. They're paying through the nose to keep this free and keep it available for everyone. And also it keeps crashing. So, you know, more and more people are definitely using it. The stat was, I think, 5 million users within the first week. Now that we're like 5 or 6 weeks in, I don't know how many, I'm guessing 10 times that at least.
Rainy also comments, apparently this person really used a lot of ChatGPT, and this person says anything generated by AI is your art. It belongs to you. Is it correct? I guess so. Like the copyright.
I know there's a lot of like copywriting. There's a lot of like artists up in arms right now because of the AI being trained with other people's art. I don't know. Yeah. Like that's, I don't really have an opinion on that. When it comes to who owns the copyright, I don't know. I honestly don't know. I feel like that's something that could be contested in the future. It sounds like Rainey like believes that it is yours and you do have the right to copyright it, but I see so much controversy about this. So I honestly, I wouldn't be surprised if like there are class action lawsuits by artists and stuff like that that come out about this, but I'm not so worried about it. It's something that's used by so many people and is like already ubiquitous. Yeah, I'm not concerned about any kind of copyright issues or anything from this art. It's so unique, and also nobody could prove anything because it's unique every single time. There's nothing that you could say that it's stolen from or anything. So it's, yeah, using it commercially, I don't think there's any problem with it.
And another use case, Jennifer is mentioning that they have seasonable products, gift niche, and AI will help them to easily change the product description.
That's a cool one. Yeah, I like that. That's a cool one. Yeah, for seasonal products that have different uses based on the season. You know, if you use it in your pool during the winter, but you use it in your house and your sink during the summer or whatever, or the other way around. That's cool. Yeah, I like that. That's a good one. That's a really
and
good one.
Vanessa is asking, how can ChatGPT be used to analyze Excel files of PPC?
Oh, that's basically the same answer as before. I wouldn't use it to adjust your bids and budgets, but you could use it to pull insights based on the customer search terms that are top converting and have the most volume. So like we did with the customer avatar exercise, like we did with updating the listing copy based on the highest converting terms from the past 30 days. These are the types of things you can do using your PPC search term report and ChatGPT.
And a few happy people. Plus one says, good speaker, thanks. Tony says, great content again. Jennifer, we are starting to a blog with backlinks with GPT.
Oh, it's Jennifer Baker. Oh, what's up, Jennifer? cool. Yeah, no, I know. Yeah. That's another thing. I didn't mention this, but we talked about this morning in our internal mastermind and Sophie is that one of the strategies for driving Google traffic to Amazon listings is because people search Amazon for products, right? People search Google for information, right? So to drive Google traffic to Amazon listings, one of the common strategies that brands that are successful know, and my buddy Travis Ziegler, who also runs a different PPC agency, but he's a buddy of mine. And we were in the same mastermind like years ago. He sold eye care products. He grew his eye care products partially with this strategy of creating content like blogs, driving traffic from Google to those blogs, and then those blogs go link to his Amazon listings. And so this is one thing that you could use ChatGPT for, is generating your own blog like Jennifer is doing, and that's around your niche. And then you drive Google traffic instead of straight to your listings, because people aren't searching Google for products, they're searching Google for information. You drive them to the blog, and then the blog is what links to your Amazon listings. So now you have no excuse not to generate content for your blog, which is really cool.
All right. We have one question about your challenge. Let me find it. Basically, it was... if I'm getting ready to launch my first product, would this PPC challenge be suitable?
No, this is not for people who are getting ready to launch their products or are just getting into this. It's only for active sellers who are currently selling. And that's, I don't say that to be mean. It's just you. It's such an active and engaged. It's not a webinar. The challenge is an interactive, engaging, high intensity 5-day experience that transforms a seller's ability to be effective with their PPC. You just can't participate if you don't have an active seller account and you're not actively selling, unfortunately. But we are going to run more of these later on in the year. We're going to do another one, probably mid to the end summer. So once you are launched, Rainey, we'd be happy to have you in the next one. Augustus, I can't hear you, buddy. I don't know if you're muted or if it's me.
Yeah, I'm muted.
Ah, there we go.
Yeah, so Muhammad says, Chris, you are the one among some of the genius minds in Amazon space.
Jennifer, nice.
Yeah, Jennifer was saying, wow, for the content. John says, amazing. And Mohit is asking, is ChatGPT server down?
Yeah, does it happen? That's been happening pretty frequently, actually. It will probably only last minutes, like when it's happened to me before, like... I literally just wait a couple minutes and come back. They're just so overloaded with users right now because it's exploding worldwide that they can barely keep up with the server load. So that's the issue. But they always come back up within minutes. So yeah, just amazing. Hang in there. Try again.
All right. Jennifer says, we crashed it. Yeah, of course.
Yeah, we did. We crashed it doing this webinar. Nice.
All right. So last time, please remind us everything what people need to know about you, what you do, and also we'll remind about the PPC challenge they can join.
Yeah. I'm Chris Rawlings, CEO of Sophie Society. We are the best PPC optimizers in the space. And so if you want your PPC handled, come to us. We also have conversion services where we use science to make your listing have a better conversion. So we're happy to help you with that as well. And yeah, for those of you who are looking to get better at PPC and learn some of these PPC strategies, I'd love to have you in the challenge if you are an active and committed seller. So yeah, for those of you guys that do join, I will see you in the challenge.
And the link to the challenge you will find below in the description, or you can watch the replay to get the QR code to scan, or Chris email if you want to get, I already forgot.
the list of prompts, the prompt engineering prompts for ChatGPT and Midjourney.
Perfect. Thank you very much. And goodbye, Chris.
Thanks, guys. Peace, guys.
And now I would like to invite you to watch other video with Chris, which we recently recorded or actually went live. And he shared five improvements on your A+ content and Amazon product listing, which will increase your conversions.